In reality, nobody sees carbon. Nobody knows what carbon is. Carbon is a molecule that nobody sees. When you talk about environmental impact, when you talk about carbon dioxide emissions, these are things that we don't see. But one thing that we see is the change in soil by adding carbon dioxide into the soil. So we think about actually replenishing organic matter. We think about enhancing microbial life in the soil. So it's about shifting from something that people don't see to something that they can see and touch, which is the soil.
We're not your typical conventional farm. The move to more environmentally friendly practices has been a process, and we're asking Mother Nature to come alongside of us here and go with us.
I think our kids are probably the only kids in the school district that know what carbon sequestering is.
You can just see how nice and mellow that soil really is. This is soil, this isn't dirt.
Yeah, I think it definitely bugs some of the boys that I know more about it than them.
When we first started strip tillage and cover crops, we were doing it because it gained efficiency for us. It was sustainable for our farm, but we realized it was checking all the boxes, that we were not only being more sustainable for ourselves, but also the environment.
The Jeffersons are an example of really important movement happening in agriculture right now. Traditionally, you would see farms in the spring with fields of exposed soil, brown for as far as the eye could see. Farmers plow or till the ground to prevent weeds and get the soil ready for planting. But there are incredible benefits to keeping that soil covered. Not plowing, which is called no-till, or reducing the amount of tillage, and planting cover crops, plants that grow into the winter between seasons. This approach can help regenerate soil health and play a big role in fighting climate change.
When you look at no-till fields or even cover crops growing or leaving some of that old crop in the field, it doesn't look as pretty. The things that look ugly on top really are creating this beautiful environment underneath for the microorganisms that are living there. Somehow soil has become beautiful to me, and that's not something I thought would happen.
So how can this help fight climate change? The short answer is naturally, biologically. Plants are kind of like nature's solar panels. They use sunlight to convert water and carbon dioxide that has been pulled from the air into energy, releasing oxygen as a byproduct. This is a process we know as photosynthesis, and plants are incredibly efficient at it. They create more energy than they need in the form of carbohydrates, like glucose. They use some of this food to grow, and the rest moves down through the roots where it's stored into the soil. This becomes what we call soil organic carbon. If we till or plow the ground, we release this carbon back into the atmosphere. But if we keep the ground covered and undisturbed, then much of that carbon will stay into the soil. So by adding and removing greenhouse gases or carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and putting into the soil, agricultural soils can become a carbon sink.
When other farmers are leaving ground fallow, that we have something growing there and that we're constantly able to sequester that carbon and capture it and put it back where it belongs. And that's the part of it that we talk about a lot. And then it benefits us and our crop.
So I think agriculture is one of the factors that is associated with climate change. But I think it's also one of the greatest resources to change. You know, you look at the Midwest in June and July when corn is rapidly growing, and the amount of CO2 that's getting sucked up and absorbed by those corn plants, it's tremendous.
The situation that I think everybody needs to think about sustainability is not actually environmental, it's actually something that needs to be thought as a business, otherwise there's no change. There's no financial incentive for people to actually drive change. So one of the things we're actually doing is creating opportunities for farmers to be paid for the benefit that they can create into the soil. Carbon is a vehicle by which farmers get paid to actually get to that end goal. No-till and cover crops are one strategy, but it's not the only one. There's one company turning a weed into renewable jet fuel.
What I thought about this was it would be a really cool way for me to finish my career as a breeder in trying to develop a crop that had never been developed before. Not very many people have done that.
And for me, I was like, that's a crazy idea, because I had worked on row crops, I had worked on sorghum, I had worked on peanuts, and I knew how difficult it was to make a small change. But it was also a cool idea that you could increase the land productivity. I was given data, and it was a situation where it was like trying to find a needle in a haystack. I just didn't know what I was looking for. So I wanted to give up on that project and just move on somewhere. But somewhere I got addicted to this crop, and I found a solution. I found the needle in the haystack, actually. CoverCress can grow during a time of year where you're not growing anything, you're not using new land, you're not using new equipments or new resources. Overall, you're trying to utilize that fallow period to make this forever green.
It's about turning, species that pretty much was a weed into something that can produce oil and therefore biodiesel and therefore sustainable aviation fuel with a much lower footprint compared to other alternatives. So the cool thing about CoverCress to me is making that land more productive with a specific purpose of changing our fuel or energy matrix.
From a farmer's standpoint, CoverCress is very useful in that many farmers want to grow a cover crop, but it costs them to grow a cover crop. So in our case, what happens is just the simple fact that the farmer not only has a cover crop, but he has a cover crop that pays.
So plants are renewable. You could grow them year after year. You can replenish them, not like other resources, natural resources. Once you pull them out, you have no way to replenish them unless you wait for centuries or millions of years. Whereas with plants, if you do the right things in a sustainable way, you could be cycling the material and producing the same quantity of material that is needed to feed or provide fuel or provide fiber to the human population.
We get really excited to think that some of the things that we're doing on our farm, if they were implemented on other farms, could be a huge part of solving the problem of climate change.
Imagine the impact that practice could have. Millions of fields, full of cash crops and cover crops, pulling carbon out of the air into the soil and keeping it there. That's what makes agriculture so unique in the fight against climate change.
You know, I don't think there is a time in a day when I don't think about this crop. I just can't stop thinking about it every day.